They are full of enthusiasm and awareness of modern technologies. But they need to be further trained as leaders. We need people to strengthen India's position as a global leader and achieve the standards of efficiency and productivity of countries like USA, UK, and more than them. We need to maintain democracy and strengthen the capabilities and attitude of existing leaders and youth of the country. We need to fight terrorism, social and regional conflicts, Naxalism and farmer suicides. We need to remove poverty and empower women. Good public leadership is the solution to all these problems. It is a great opportunity for our youth to become leaders in a variety of areas, like being an elected leader as Sarpanch of a village, Pramukh of a village panchayat, an MLA, an MP. One has to contest elections to become such a leader. The other avenues for public leadership include the civil services, judiciary, armed forces, entrepreneurship, cooperative society leaders, labor leaders, non-government organization leaders, women leaders, spiritual leaders, leaders in sports, leaders in the film industry, leaders in cultural fields such as dance, music, artists, designers, voluntary leaders, educational leaders in schools, colleges, and universities, leadership for specialized associations, trade and industry, Chambers of Commerce, Shareholders Association, etc. Public leadership is the need of the hour for the betterment of society.
Sidhu?
Yes, Dadu?
Look, Sidhu, I have something for you.
What is it, Dadu? Oh, wow, a book on entrepreneurship. Thank you, Dadu.
You're welcome, Sidhu.
Well, I have something for you too.
Oh, Amul chocolate. Thank you. Let's have it right away.
So, Dadu, tell me more about entrepreneurs.
And entrepreneurship is a very exciting opportunity for you youngsters in public leadership. An entrepreneur is someone who takes initiative to start business on one's own. It could be a textile manufacturing unit, providing a certain service, or even a brainwave like your YouTube, Orkut and Facebook. But one doesn't always have to own a company to do great things. You can become the managing director of a company like Anil Naik of L&T fame or V. Kamath of ICICI and make great progress.
Starting something on someone's own. Sounds tough.
Well, Sidhu, for a man of determination, there is no stopping. Take the example of Ambani, a lower middle class boy. He started as a vendor and went on to establish Reliance Industries and Communication, which contribute so much in an Indian's life, like mobiles, textiles, energy, petroleum, and share values.
And what about the man behind Amul, Dadu? Is he also an entrepreneur?
Amul is a result of team efforts of Sri Tribhuvan Das and Dr. Varghese Kurian. It is a cooperative society movement which comprises of the union of thousands of farmers who come together at the village level to form the Milk Producers Society. The milk that these farmers sold within their village amongst themselves now reaches the world outside. This gives them monetary benefit and many village women financial independence. This movement was started in our very own Anand by Sri Tribhuvan Das and then multiplied all over India under the professional expertise of Dr. Kurian. So now, Sidhu, you see the great history behind our Amul Bar?
Well, what about the armed forces? Didn't you have a friend there?
No. There is no such friend of mine that I can remember of. But I will tell you about them all the same. The armed forces is one of the most challenging assignments for young people who want to do something for the nation. Look at Sam Manekshaw. It was under his planning and commands that India won the war against Pakistan in 1971. Now you see how important such people are to keep together a nation.
Nations, organizations have grown whenever they have good leaders. And it is equally true that bad leaders have created chaos. Countries have lost their freedom. People have become poor, lost lives to the continuing conflict. In case of organizations, they have become bankrupt and thousands of people have lost their hard-earned money and jobs. Hitler is an example of a leader of immense intelligence and charisma, who was followed blindly by many, but who created immense loss to humanity because of his warped ideals. This led ultimately to his own downfall and to be remembered in history as one of the most hated men. It is not sufficient to make it to the top of the ladder. Once on the top, one has to become more vigilant and be able to maintain that position. Thus, to prevent one's own downfall, it is important for a leader to observe symptoms like overconfidence, not listening to others, arrogance, the know-all attitude, taking decision on misinformation, disregard for public opinion, making people fight, killing people who criticize him or her. Such people destroy their own self. Millions of lives, millions of people, millions of roles. Some are forgotten, some are remembered, some for their bad deeds, and others for their good ones. Good leaders have a glorious end. They are remembered over the ages and respected by generations.
Siddhant Sharma,